thing.
No.
Gal.
Yeah, you got it. My wish is just gonna be JB with, like, look at the little Japanese stuff I have.
What are you talking about?
Nothing.
Yeah, I'm showing off, bud. That's what I get this shit for.
Okay, whatever.
Flex
bitch.
On kids.
Small. It's LDE.
Small.
Dude, I
can I add things to the soundboard?
Sure.
Or do you have to do it?
You can definitely add stuff.
Damn.
What do you got?
Ooh. Nothing.
Nothing.
Void Walkers.
I got some nightmare sounds.
I got some good ones.
What do you need? There's the best ones already on here. You don't need anything else.
Paper player is stupid.
That one's good. I haven't played that one in a while. I'm a big fan of that one. I've been trying to find that TikTok of, like, where it's like squanchy, slurshy, slodge, or whatever, and I can't find, like, the isolated noise from it, and I don't feel like being on TikTok for an hour to find it.
What?
Are you talking about the, like,
Family Guy, like, squanchy, slosh. Like, I don't know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Ask Hunter. He knows everything.
What about the...
Go on. We'll get started here soon, guys. We'll get started here soon. Oh, you guys playing Marvel Snap?
Sure you're not talking about Rick and Morty?
No. There's a cat that says, like, squanch this, squanch that, but there's, like, a TikTok, like, meme where it's, like, where they fart and go, oh. And then they go, oh, like, it's like a girl, like, shooting, or a girl or a guy shooting their pants, and they go, like, sloshy swanch.
I hate whatever you're talking about.
I don't know. You're not in.
It sounds awful.
Yeah, well, that's why I wanted it, because it would just annoy you to no end, but instead, I got bubblegum.
Yeah, this one, too.
I hate what...
Ba-oop-ba-doop-ba, bubblegum. Ba-oop. Remember when you guys went to camp? Remember those camp songs?
Not that one.
You don't want to know the songs that I was listening to at camp, bro.
Oh, really? What, are you listening to Slipknot? I'm fucking tough.
No. I saw Spangle at summer camp.
Spangle?
Spangle. The one actual alien on Earth.
What are you talking about?
I'm listening.
Hang on. Let me get...
We'll get that on the cast. Let's talk about summer camp.
Summer camp.
Oh, we should do that. We should do
My
a magic.
My parents are too broke.
We should have a magic summer camp where everybody's required to just be isolated in a campsite for a week and just be angry that all of our cards are flying to the wind.
I mean, don't they have that magic cruise coming back this year, too?
Cruises? I mean, I guess cruises are cool if you like just eating slop from the same kitchen.
Slop. Slop.
It's all, You were on TikTok for a minute, Jeff, right?
I went.
Do you know when
I watched you talk about it? The slop,
the squishy squash.
Slop. Yes, I do know what you're talking about.
I can't find that isolated noise. It's like Peter Griffin saying like squishy squash or something like that, and it's like someone farts and they poop their pants and it's like slurpy slosh.
It's awful.
I can't find it isolated. You guys are so fucking lucky. It would be on your ad nauseum. All right, let's get this thing started. Because you guys are crying.
I think I know how to find it, but I'm definitely
I've tried. I've tried.
You underestimate how often my girlfriend is on TikTok and can find stuff.
Well, I mean, the problem is I had to spend an hour to do it, and I was like, I don't want Facebook noises, so I gotta. Switch. Stop it.
What?
Nothing. Josh is being a twerp.
I said, you gotta type in Divine Moments of Truth into YouTube. That's the song you want.
Is it that a really loud one?
No, it's the DMT song.
Okay. We'll play that. Maybe we'll do that here. Let me go find that. What is it called? Divine Truths?
Divine Moments of Truth. The song's actually really good.
Divine Moments of Truth. Okay. That's going to be our theme song this week. It's 10 minutes. Are you serious?
Please, dude. All
right, fine. We'll play it. You guys got 10 minutes to burn? 3, 2, 1, theme song. When does it? When I need it.
He's actually an alien.
He's like the Juggalo sign.
He does have a dick for a hand.
The Spangle image. It's a mushroom guy.
Is there a new theme? Right now, I'm okay with that. We have a new theme song, guys.
Dude, I'm in. For what it's worth, we're live. I'm just gonna
start we're live.
About my weekend. My weekend where I blasted off on DMT for the first time over the weekend.
Are you done talking shit about it? Did you go to the Nitro realm?
I mean, I'll stop talking shit about it, but it's still it's not like what Joe Rogan's fucking spit. It's not what Joe Rogan's.
How is the shadow?
It's not like
days.
Oh my god, it's the greatest thing ever. But it was definitely like oh shit.
But seriously, did you go to the Shadow Realm?
Yeah, like how was it?
God, I don't know if Shadow. I guess I handle my psychedelics really well. I didn't go to the Shadow Realm, but I definitely like. Literally, I went to Cartoon World almost.
All right, before you get into that, welcome to episode 115, Jumpstart Can't Even. I'm so glad they discontinued that product. Spoilers, by the way. I'm your host, Tony, and I'm joined with Josh, Jeff, and JB. But before we get into all that, the best way to find us is through a million different socials. Just go to our link tree. You'll see everything. Yes, we're on Threads, the hotness that's coming up that nobody uses. Yes, we're on it. You better believe I've threaded, is that what they call it, once. So,
I saw that Threads is just like Twitter or whatever. Is that like Facebook's Twitter? Is that what it's?
But
to
it's really bad because the hashtags don't work because the hashtags aren't hashtags, so you can't like. Anyways, go on Threads, follow us there. Make us be the first thread. Cool. Yeah, make us popular. All right, Josh, tell me about your trip into the Shadow Realm.
He was about to walk away to go back.
So We woke up Sunday morning, which is Tipper Day, and then Detox Unit was doing a hammock set or whatever for 2 hours at like 2 p.m. or something like that.
Real
so
quick, in case no one knows what tippers are, it's where you get up and tip cows in the morning.
Tipper is arguably the best DJ alive. But anyway, so 2 p.m. we make it over to the hammock area. So and we found a really good spot. And like we didn't bring any hammocks or shit, like or anything. Like we both found a hammock, and I got kicked out of mine twice. The guy came back and was like, "I want to use it," or whatever. But there is this chair next to Evan's hammock, and I just sat in that chair. And I sat in that chair for 5 hours, and no one ever came back.
Is this? Right? Can I ask you something real quick?
So in this chair. Huh?
I'm going to ask you one question. When you were in that chair, is this what was going through your mind?
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
What?
So I'm like in this chair and like in the cup holder, I noticed like, you know, quite quickly that I thought what was in there was like cigarettes that got wet or whatever.
Nothing worse than that.
And so I just like ignored it or whatever. And I just like enjoyed the music for a while. And then, but after like, you know, at 2 hours or so, I got kind of curious and I like dug in there and see it. So there's this lighter in there. And then, they weren't cigarettes. They were actually joints. Right. So I like pull them out and I'm looking at them and like, it looked like there was like, at first I thought they were wet, but after like inspection, it was like there was something in it or whatever. And I thought of maybe I was like, I bet these have DMT in it. But
I'm just gonna smoke this random
so
thing.
So I found one that didn't like look like it had obviously anything in it, and I handed it to Evan, right?
Oh my
and
god.
Evan was like,
that's
oh, you
the
found
worst.
A joint, and he sparked it up, right? And we started smoking this joint, and then you know, about a minute later, I'm like, the colors start getting real freaking vibrant and my heart starts beating real fast and this dude's shirt start, he's got like this like psychedelic, okay. You know how psychedelic
I want to say one forever. Thing about this.
Yes.
I thought you were going to be a dick and you were going to be like, here, test this out for me. And then not smoke it after he did.
No, I just handed it to him. He lit it and okay, smoked okay, it. And then we both.
That's a little better. That's way better than what I thought.
We're
was
going down. Like,
dude,
together.
That is the worst move
hey, can
ever.
Can you taste this right. poison for me?
And then, like, I start getting the body high or, like, it comes on real hard or whatever. And I'm like, oh shit, the demon was in here. And, like, everything, all the colors are very bright, and like everything's moving. This dude's shirt, the psychedelic T-shirt guy,
just
next
to get
to
caught off of YouTube, by the way,
just was like completely going in and out of itself or whatever, and like everything was moving. And then, so that it only lasts about like 10 minutes or whatever. And then after like that, I tap on Evan's like hammock, and I was like, "Bro, are you tripping real hard?" And he was like. Yeah, this weed's hitting, bro. And I'm like, nah, dude, I don't think that's it. And then that's when I showed him the rest of them. I was like, I think there was demons in there, dude. And then he's like, oh, shit. And then he took the rest of them. Yeah. And then so we proceeded throughout the day. And then when Tipper came on, we smoked a bunch of more demons and then blasted off again. And then it was like kind of the same. But that was like a little...
why? Please, Tony, stop.
That was like a little, it was wild because like I was standing and everything was like very vibrant and like kind of like, I don't know, like kind of like a pondering my orb thing. I saw like a giant orb and everything was just kind of going into the orb.
Episode 420. Yeah, that's right, Jimbo.
Is this episode, is no. this episode 420? And then oh like after God. Tipper was over, like... We didn't want to go to bed or whatever. We didn't want it to end. So we made our way over to Papa Dozio, and then we found this, like...
what are these names?
I like it. Keep it coming.
Papa Dozio is really good. You should give him a shot. Those That's a band that... It's actually... It's not a DJ. That's a band. And mm-hmm. I think all of you guys would like them. They're pretty chill. But so we make our way over to Papa Dozio, and then we get up onto this, like, castle kind of thing, and we're, like, watching it from the top. And then we meet this girl who, like, has this obvious, like, UK accent. Because Tipper's a UK artist.
Oi.
So and he draws a big
crime.
And then she starts talking to us about Tipper and retelling her about how he DMT blasted off. And she's like, you want to do it again? And, like, pulls this, fuck, DMT pen out of her tits. So there we are again at, like, 2 a.m. Tip blasting off to Papa Dozio again. And then that one was really cool because there was like a spider web over the crowd. And then like I saw like just like an actual like art installation spider web kind of thing. And like that was like the like colors were like traversing through the spider web. And like, yeah, I don't know, it was really cool.
Yeah.
Everything was really sparkly. And, things got kind of fractally. And then that was the end of DM. I can't forget her name. Like Katie, I think her name was. Evan would remember because Evan was in love with her.
Nice.
But,
shout out to Evan.
yeah.
Doing it for you. DMT you experience. And Katie.
Stay in school.
And
kids.
Like another thing, like this like Timber and Friends event that I went to is like different from any other music festival I went to because there's like no alcohol, like sales anywhere. Oh. You could bring your own alcohol, but you couldn't buy any. So like everyone was really fucking nice. I never have gotten so much free like party favors in my entire life.
Nice.
People were just handing them to me.
Yes, Colby, that is fun.
Or like leaving joints of DMT in the chair with a lighter. Like here, smoke me. It was almost like, you know, like Alice in Wonderland, where it's like the mushrooms are like eat me.
Yeah.
That was my weekend.
YouTube's gonna be like,
that's it. You're banned.
Yeah. They will.
Whatever, worth it.
Good luck, YouTube. You'll never take me. I still got three strikes left.
Some quick samples.
What I mean
of them.
Is, if they're watching our podcast, and I give them a high five for that. Thanks for supporting us, guys.
Yeah,
Nate, what's up?
I took a quick peek into that band, and I found a really jazzy album, and I think it's A-okay.
Hi,
what,
dude.
Cool. What album, Papa Dozio?
Yeah,
yeah, they're good.
Tatios or something.
Nate,
you should listen to the Microdosio album. That one. That one's got all the bangers on it.
Okay.
All right. Any cool magic stuff that you guys want to talk about?
I went to Friday night Legacy in the Corner.
Oh, yeah!
And couldn't stay super long, but it's always fun because the dudes that we do it with, shout out to those dudes. You know who you are.
Gaddock Tigers.
Yep, the Tigers. We just like hand our decks around to one another and just play anyone's deck at any time and just switch and swap around, and it's great.
It's pretty chill crew.
I always have a lot of fun. Just kind of chilling in the corner, talking about how we're going to waste more money on old Magic cards, buy new stuff for Legacy, rotating format. Welcome Legacy, the new rotating format.
Oh, man. We can talk about some Legacy stuff because they just printed some Legacy stuff. I don't know if anyone's
yeah,
played
I also...
What?
Wilds.
I also... Huh?
Keep going.
Oh, yeah. I also collected, got these in the mail. My four of Greaves, four of Orcish Bowmasters, and four of Voidwalkers, Dothy Voidwalkers.
That camera quality.
All
yes.
in Japanese.
Crisp.
Real nice.
Everyone can see what it is.
I know, dude. I hate my camera.
Yeah, don't you have... Do you need $50?
Cause
all
no,
you're doing,
it's
you're
because
sending it all
also,
to Japan.
Discord limits you to 480p on your cameras.
Damn
unless
it.
You pay.
We got to get Nitro, boys.
Yeah. But yeah, so I'm basically done with Rakdos Scam in Japanese, which
yeah,
is other than the lands, which is great.
Shout out to it.
Yeah.
I double drafted on Sunday. I did. Nice. We did. Oh, what was the first one we did? Oh, we did War of the Spark. Went 1-2. There was a Karn and a Teferi opened. And then we did Dominaria United, and I went red, white, aggro, and I went 3-0.
Ooh.
Did you beat up and steal those cards like you did the week before from the other draft?
What do you mean beat up and steal those?
Didn't you like beat people up and steal their cards when they opened a really good one?
He knows what you're talking about.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell us about your theft.
Not this time.
This is the podcast episode where we confess it all and go to jail.
Yeah.
That's why you changed the name to We're Telling the Truth.
Dude, we're all about to die to Doomblade.
Thanks, Saf.
But yeah, it was fun. We're trying to do another draft this coming weekend. I don't know what set we're doing, but been enjoying like drafting in person. It's nice to like hop around and not do the same set over and over like on Arena.
Yeah. Also, just touching cards feels so good.
It does.
Yeah. Dude, good thing you don't ever play, Tony. It's great.
I know. It's my biggest downfall.
He doesn't play, but he opens packs. That's for sure.
He just talks about it.
I like organizing my cards all the time. It's like the time. So, like, do you remember when you first got into Magic and you had, like, all... Well, Josh especially, because I think you got into it in high school. You had all the time in the world, but nowhere to play. And now you have... like
no all, time but all, have it
all the places to play, like you, it's like literally Magic's on demand all the time. You can open up Arena, open up MTGO, they always got like leagues going, and then you can, you know, and then there's rental services. Whereas like you go back to like 2010, like I remember just going home after like only being able to play FNM and just being like, man, I want to play some more, and just like sorting my cards and like making new decks.
Oh,
Jeff, remember when we would just take the bag of, like, a literal garbage bag full of commons, and we'd be like,
we
have to make
decks
only out of the cards in this bag.
I mean, yeah. I love that little kid stuff. Like, it's like my favorite.
I made that five-color Decree of Annihilation deck.
And then eventually it got to the point where, like, I got my driver's license, and we would just run to Walmart, and we would just buy
like
three packs
or
whatever.
At
4 in the morning, buy three packs of whatever we could find, and then come home and draft.
Yeah. All right.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that was the future site block most of the bit.
Yeah, that sounds like that's actually pretty tits. All right, so show notes for today: we got Beetle and Grimms, Mishmash creatures, sick Wild Devil Drain stuff, Jumpstart can't even jump a battery, exclusives for Eternal, more anime. What's up?
More anime.
Oi! All right, and then
I'm ready.
And they also revealed the two full deck lists for the Commander decks. And they are stacked. They're pretty good. Like, they have really good...
Really?
Yeah, they have, like, high reprint value in them. It's, like, really sick.
But dude, I just saw that post that you made an hour ago about that fairy thing.
That card is so awesome.
I can't wait.
That
oh
card
my
is
God.
So awesome.
Way too much mana, but the card is...
I don't care.
I love that card.
It doesn't matter.
That card is, like...
Wait, which fairy?
Right in my deck.
We'll talk about it. It's so sick. All right. Right from the get-go, remember last year during this time they did, like, the Kamigawa, like, $500... You know, you spend this much money, you get like these. Yeah. They did like a much more budget version this time around, which is good on them. So
where
is that?
When?
A lunchbox? That's amazing.
Yeah, Beetle.
Where did I buy this?
BeetleandGrim.com.
Oh.
So they
can do it right now.
You can still buy the new
like
you can still buy the new Kamigawa stuff.
Oh, okay.
Interesting. So I'm going to go look at it. I didn't know it was a thing.
Yeah, so they have it comes with a lunchbox. It comes with these cool roll tokens, which looks a lot better. They're metal. So
I did see this.
Yep, and it also comes with this pretty cool life counter.
Oh, my God.
I think rules. Like, Sir Ginger's the shit. And then these little plus one tokens and these plus five tokens.
His wife, because he's dead.
I want those to be pins so bad. If those were pins, I would immediately.
They use the I think it, I might be saying non binary. It's SYR, so it's unisex maybe. Maybe that's I don't know. So it's Sir Ginger. And
no,
these
like a royal. It's like a like the sir in the like.
Surname
UK royalty or whatever is not
like knighted.
Okay, I thought it was a that's on me. I thought that was a.
Why
a
do these dice thing? Look like they're made of caramel?
That's because they are. I wish
the caramel cubes. Dude.
That'd be pretty sick. But these things rule. The entire package is right here. You can get it's $40 for the dice, the life counter, the metal tokens, the
those are metal.
Box. Yeah, these right here are metal. They ting. Like they're that. Super loud.
That's pretty good.
They were showing them on stream, like, ting, 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 ting. I was like, damn, these are annoying.
Now I kind of want that.
Yeah. And you can also buy separately a Sir Ginger hoodie.
That I will pass on.
Yeah, this is pretty
medium. I want that.
The lunchbox, I don't care about. The life counter. The life counter is cool.
Yeah.
I like the metal tokens.
Mm-hmm.
I like when they make weird tokens, like the Japanese ones that I got that are like those thick, clear plastics. Oh, yeah.
So
great.
You can do this with 4 free installments of ShopPay.
Oh, great.
I can't believe sites are doing layaway. Anyways, this is the thing that came
out for a long time, dude.
I know. But yeah, it's pretty sick. So this is a cool product. I like it. The guy that is I forget his name, but he's Shaggy and Scooby Doo.
Oh, Matthew.
There you go.
Something.
Yeah, it's
his own card store.
Yeah, I think he is Beetle and Grimm or whatever that is. So it's pretty cool. I like when they do this like tag team promotional stuff because this is, it's unique in that way. All right. First, let's get to it. I just want to say that Saffron Olive, you stole from me. Okay. This is totally not photoshopped, even though this is something that's really easy to Photoshop. When they revealed this mouse, I said this. Come on. Who would win in a fight, mouse or lions? And they're both. I have a 8th edition Savannah lions next to a cheeky house mouse, and then shortly after, steals my valor, and does this. You're a jerk, Saf. That's all I can say.
You're a jerk.
You know, talk about.
Paper players doesn't exist at this point.
Okay, like
you and then go and take this from
you,
us.
You clearly watched the show or listened to the show, so you know it exists. Don't mess with me. Okay. Anyways, that being said, I tried to go in depth on this, and then like magic research is really difficult, especially if someone hasn't already done the work. So, who'd win a fight, guys? A Savannah Lions or a cheeky house mouse?
House mouse. Every day.
I know, this bullshit, dude. Come on, mate. Poor Savannah Lions. Remember, this was a rare.
Okay, so if the ring isn't fully cursed, does that mean it still has a magic ability on it? It's just not a negative.
I like this card.
Great.
This is my favorite. This is my favorite card.
Josh, tell me. If the ring is almost done getting cursed, does that mean there's some magic in it already?
I almost done cursing. Yeah, there's some magic in there.
Okay, so that's why he's way better than a lion. He's got magic on his side.
That makes way more sense. He's cheeky. He's smarter. He can say like funny jokes and insults the lion. The lion goes, oh, my heart, owie.
Haven't you ever watched cartoons? The lions are always afraid of the mice, in the
Speed
circus.
Beats power every time. Down goes tight. Down goes Frasier.
Yeah, all right, then. That being said, I wanted to make this into a segment, and I wanted to put out to our audience if they can outbrain us. Can you find some pretty good who would wins that are just like flavor fails and magic? Okay, and I'll show you one that
is this really a fail
versus bear, bro.
Lions losing to a mouse, yeah, or lions tying with a mouse. But what about this one, guys? Okay, what about
It's Mary the DMT fairy.
That's a pretty good name.
Was the lady on the top rope?
Who would win in a fight? cleanup crew with a guy with a broom, a guy with this, or Vorinclex.
Oh, wow.
They actually tie.
I don't know. I can't tell because I don't have flavor text, and that's how I judge who would actually win. I don't care about their abilities. I just care about the flavor text.
Do you guys ever get salty about cards like that ever? Like when a card like doesn't make sense from PT size? I didn't think so.
How, it's three humans are normally 2/2s. That makes sense to me.
No, humans are 1/1s. Elspeth makes 1/1s. Soldiers are 1/1s.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, this card's a little push.
Well, cleanup crew is old.
But I take Vorinclex.
Yeah, everyone takes take Vorinclex. Because a guy with a broom is not beating Vorinclex. Okay? This guy doubles your stuff.
He's got armor. This used to be my favorite meme format, but...
No, I want to see a video of Vorinclex getting beat up by a cleanup crew.
Three people in Duke Capetta.
An Emrakul or 15 squirrels?
Well, obviously. Yeah, that's the classic
one. Emrakul because it's
Or
flies.
Both. How about you just take both?
It's 15 squirrels. That's all I got for who you would win. I was trying to do more of it, and then I got really bored of trying to find it. All right. Wild's Little Drain's got more and more cool stuff coming out. I'm just going to talk about some of the things that I liked from the set so far. I looked at the spoilers today. They finished the cycle of the red and the green one of the adventure with large enchantment. Oh. Yeah, those are pretty cool. But Rankle's Prank, baby. This card's sick. It is Barter and Blood and then some. RIP people who play Barter and Blood. You just got your super upgrade.
No, I play that in the cube.
Barter and Blood, yeah.
How long before Sprankle's Prankle goes down to uncommon?
The louder they scream, the harder he laughs. Rankle's so mean.
Ooh, I like that flavor text.
That's pretty good. Yeah.
I mean, I'll definitely put that in my EDH. I'll put it in my EDH. Oh, boys, I'm starting to say it to everything. That one's going into my EDH. I'm becoming that guy.
So this card has so many goddamn words. I'm not going to read it. But Feral Encounter, which is green for a sorcery.
Exile creature among them. Put the rest on the bottom of your library in random order. That's the exile card this turn. Beginning of your next combat phase, target creature you control deals damage equal to its power to one target creature. So it's look at the top five exile creature, you can cast it and it fights something on combat.
It's like Adventurous Impulse and Prey Upon put on the same card.
And you kind of get to it gives something pseudo haste almost.
Yeah, because it's going to attack. Either way, this card has so many goddamn words on it. I bet you people are going to script playing this card at pre-release just because it's infinite cards.
No one's
going
to play this at the pre-release. They're going to be like, it's too many words. I'm not going to read it. Let me find a 2/2.
Yeah.
Sounds like what I do.
Questing Druid. This should be Josh's invitational card.
Oh, yes.
Oh, agreed.
This card's sick, dude.
Green me.
Yeah.
Seek the Beast. Exile top two cards of the library.
This card is real good.
Oh, wow. This card is good.
Yeah.
You like that he has Questing Beast on his staff?
And Dryad? Dude, I love this card already.
He's got to have Questing Beast on his staff. That's cool.
That is cool. Yeah.
Power Crept, Quirion Dryad.
And then Ren's... It's like they put Quirion Dryad and Ren's Resolve on the same card. But yeah, fact that this instant speed is really
sick. It's insane, yeah.
Yeah, super dope. Love this card. Good.
The art is great.
Yeah, the card's just good, man. It's a good card. All right, the Iron Crag.
I don't like this card.
Yeah, it's two mana or mana rock.
Tries too hard. Two mana or mana rocks aren't that great.
Yeah.
Especially if they tap for colorless.
Well,
all other abilities.
So it loses the ability to tap for a mana when you play a legendary creature. It loses this ability. It becomes a crappy equipment.
No, the equipped creature loses it.
No. You may have the Iron Crag become a legendary equipment name, and then Hero's Legacy. If you do, it gains equipped 3 and then loses all other abilities. So it loses.
And equipped creature gets +3/+3 and loses all other abilities.
Oh, man, I read that wrong. This card's better. I thought this was a bait. I thought this was a trap. It's actually not that bad.
It's still bad.
Yeah. That's pretty far.
There's not a deck. I would put this in my Finn deck only because I sold all the good cards out of it.
And I don't think, you're a poison deck. It doesn't really matter how much, it's poison through Death Touch.
That's still bad.
Yeah, card sucks. Bad. But it's the first time we've seen a 2-mana mana rock in standard in
That's true.
Years.
And you get bonus value out of it sometimes.
Not yours, because Arcane Signet was in the first Eldraine.
How does that work in Standard?
I don't know, but it was in there.
Tell me how.
You technically play it in Standard.
No, you couldn't. You couldn't play the Broad. Yeah, you can't play. Well, I guess you could. How does that work in Standard?
It does nothing.
It doesn't
tap or anything.
Yeah. All right.
What was the other one that gives you a maximum hand size? When was the last time that was in Standard?
That wasn't in Standard. It originally got it printed. It was a Commander product.
So if I cast this from the graveyard, I can then cast it for its other half?
Yes.
Yeah, so...
Yeah,
this card's great. This is like Tenacious Underdog. Very similar.
It'll be a really good card in Standard, that's for
this
sure.
This card, because like, if you counter or stop like the adventure, normally the card will go to the graveyard, and this allows you to still cast it.
Yeah.
This card's good because it draws a card, too.
Tenacious Underdog is like a heavily played Standard card. I'm sure this card will see play. It's got similar it's got similar stats. It also has Trample. And then also the...
It's much easier to cast.
Yeah.
And
you don't have to... You can just cast it and leave it for blocking, or Blitz makes you have to attack. Well, not makes, but you should attack.
Dude, there's no other reason not.
I love all the antlers and horns in this.
Dude, they're everywhere. That's kind of a big homage to, like, is everybody trying to be Garrick? Yeah. All right. Elusive Otter.
Otter.
Yeah.
Dude, I love this card.
This card is... I'm
not
trying
my
to
favorite card.
So I'm trying to think if this is better than Soulscar Mage.
Nope.
Why not?
Because you're already paying
colors.
What do you mean?
Like, what kind of deck would this go in?
I would go in a
completely different deck.
Soulscar Mage is like good for like continuous turns, where like the Elusive of Otter is only good. The sorcery thing only happens once.
Well, and Soulscar Mage definitely helps you get around
the counters on it, but
it helps you get around some cards.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah, Soulscar like shrinks creatures. Okay. Which I mean, I guess like this means if those creatures, if you get bigger than those creatures, they can't block anyways. But I feel like they're two different decks.
Maybe. Okay. I'm just thinking, like, because Soulscar Mage is, like, I hate playing that card in those style of decks. And, like, you just make it, as it seems pretty easy to do. And then being able to not be blocked is, like, pretty huge game. But, I don't know. Right. I thought highly of the card. The Gaia's Bounty, or the Grove's Bounty, is like
whatever.
It's flavor text. You're playing it for this side because it's the prowess creature. But it does get
a
hit
bonus
by,
if you have a bunch of mana and a guy.
I wonder if it'll
just dump into
like
it.
The safest adventure they could put on it, because they knew the creature half was powerful, but like the sorcery is like flavor text.
Yeah.
Otter fodder.
Nice.
Otter fodder.
I like what you did there. Hearth Elemental. So this card is 5 and a red. It's like Talarian Terror, except a little bit more upgraded. This spell costs X less to cast, where X is the number of cards in your graveyard that are instant sorceries.
Wait. This is just ripping off of that old card that used to get played in red-black that has prowess.
Yeah.
Bedlam Reveler.
Yep.
Well, yeah.
Same thing.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Except you got to spend more mana to do this.
What's the one that does?
And Bedlam Reveler draws you 3 cards.
Is there?
Are you talking about the red white one?
Is the Stoke Genius bustable adventure? Is there a deck? Why not?
Why would it be?
How many cards in the game say discard your hand, draw a card for 2 mana?
There's better options for drawing and discarding.
Like what?
Than that at 2 mana?
Well, entire hand, not some. Entire hand.
What are you trying to do here, Madness?
I don't know. That's the thing. How valuable is it? Like, they have one with nothing, which is discard your hand.
I was about to say, because if that's what's important to you, one with nothing does it better.
Well, one with nothing has a problem, because you can't, you have to, like, respond to it. Is one with nothing a sorcerer, or is it instant?
It's a sorcerer.
So you can't, like, put something on the stack, then one with nothing?
Yeah, you can't do that with this either. This is a sorcery. What are you talking about?
My point is, with this,
you still draw something.
You still get 2 cards from it. So
yeah, whatever.
Okay. I don't know.
I think it's fine. I just don't think it's broken in any way.
Yeah, because I know, like,
discard your hand and then dredge the cards you discarded.
Yeah,
that's about the best you can do.
Well, who knows? I don't know what decks would want this. I'm sure there's other things that like benefit from being the beard.
This is something that
this is definitely a dredge toy for sure, though. This is definitely a dredge toy for sure.
Yeah.
I think Phoenix might try this.
I mean, discarding your hand and drawing two, like, immediately. I mean, if you draw two random cards, you don't know what you're going to get, but, like, how fast that is.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the idea of this card is, like, Stoke Genius, and then because you discarded your hand, you should be able to cast the 4 or 5 part for, like, a red, right? That's, like, the idea of this card. Yeah. All right. I was just looking at it. And
I like this card.
Because all the other, like, Time Twister effects always come at 3. They've never come at 2 before. And I know 2 is... you don't get full 7. I know that.
It's a lot of card difference between 2 and 7.
Also, sure. Time Twister does it for everyone. Your opponent's getting a new hand, too. This is just your side.
Yeah, it's...
This card's okay.
I just wonder if it's breakable, that's all.
How much was that Valakut card? Toy. Was
dredge
it 3?
Break it. Dredge is going to break
it.
Yeah,
the one where you discard and draw plus 1.
Yeah.
It's 3 mana.
Okay.
Yeah, they've always done it where it's like this kind of effect's always 3 of discarding hand and then drawing X cards, and now it's 2.
This card, what about with like Hollow One?
Wait, isn't there a
that's pretty good.
That does it?
Hmm?
I thought there was a 2 mana battle that made you discard your hand and draw 2.
Is there? I'm not sure.
There's definitely a dredge deck that with this card that exists.
Yeah.
It's in the colors.
Yeah. That's not bad. I think it's dredge is probably worth gonna go. I don't know. I'm just if there's a battle that does it, then like, never mind. But I don't. Maybe there is. I thought there was a battle that's like, because everything's
maybe
always
it's
like
discard 2, draw 2. But
yeah, that's usually what they do. They keep it pretty safe, and like yes, discarding your entire hand. But how many cards care about being discarded? Like Madness, and then
Hollowed One.
Discard the Hollowed One.
How could you run a deck that plays Stoke Genius, right? And then like Vengevines and then Basking Rootwallers?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What's Rootwaller do again?
It's 0 to cast if you've discarded. Zero. Yeah. And there's two, there's a red and a green one.
Eh.
Yep.
Like it's meme-y. I'm just thinking.
I mean, for meme decks.
If someone's able to, if someone's able to,
is Vengevine gonna go to $50 again?
I mean, discarding cards has always been like good, right? Like survival, it costs a green to discard stuff, but like I know survival has way higher.
Don't even talk about survival.
But like this, like I'm always looking for ways to break Vengevine.
The dog Wild Mongrel is a good card and very comparable to this.
Yeah, that's fair.
You can discard your hand to Wild Mongrel, and people do it.
Is there a way
you get to select?
Is there no? Okay.
Does it matter if you're discarding your whole hand?
Yeah, like who cares? There's a.
What I'm saying is, Wild Mongrel is like I can choose to do this now.
Yeah.
Yeah, and changes color. All right. Anyways, it's similar to Talarian Terror. I wonder if there will be like an instant sorcery deck with this.
Maybe. I mean, I'm not saying it's terrible. It's just I don't think it's as good.
I hope someone's got a better shot, like modern.
I think it's got a better. Modern than
well, the older the form, the older format, right? The older you go, the more power it gains, because things just do things. This is my favorite card.
Now this card,
you're really hot on this card.
I want to see this card get spicy.
Up the beanstalk. Yep. So up the beanstalk.
It's a 2 mana do nothing.
Well,
it
draws
no.
A card
it's
ATBs.
A 2 mana draw card when it comes in.
It draws in when it ATBs.
It cycles itself. That's the part that matters. So if it didn't cycle itself, I'd be like, all right, this card's not great.
No. So when up the beanstalk, enter the battlefield. Whenever you cast a spell with mana value 5 or greater, draw a card. So it enters and. So you get the draw right away. And then, like, there's so many cards right now that, like.
My big dumb legacy deck.
Yeah.
Plays all big dumb guys.
Domain things, all this other stuff. Hell, you can get crazy. Not with this card, but.
Murktide. X doesn't matter, right?
Murktide.
And then Murktide. What's up? Draw a card off Murktide.
Murktide doesn't cost 7. What are you talking about?
It costs 2. But it's mana value 7. Can't fatal push it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty sick. It works with like all
not
the
what senses. You cast it at, so it's not that. Like an X card I'll be able to be.
No, it's whenever you cast a spell with mana value, so boom. That's all it's really caring about. It's pretty good. It's pretty good.
I like it. Yeah. I don't know if it'll do anything, but I do want it to do something.
Devouring Sugar Maw. Black 2 for a horror that's an adventure. It's a 6/6. And then the adventure side has instant have for dinner, which is 1 and a white, which create a 1/1 human creature token. and a food token. So you get to make two tokens off this, and then at the beginning of your upkeep on the regular side, you may sacrifice an artifact, enchantment, or token. If you don't, tap Devouring Sugar Maw.
So is this just what's the demon?
Desecrated Demon?
Yeah. Is it just that you control if you tap it or not?
It's also got Menace. That's pretty big.
Yeah.
Menaces.
And Trample.
Yeah, and Trample. With, I don't think Desecrated Demon had Trample, did it?
It was Flying Trample, wasn't it? No, it was just Flying.
I like it. Cyan isn't played. Yeah, just... Zoo isn't real. Stop. Yeah, right. It keeps putting up results. Somebody keeps playing it. But yeah, I like the... It looks like a butthole here. A big, glizzy, glazy butthole.
I'm glad that's the first thing that comes to your mind.
Well, come on. It looks like he's got hemorrhoids. It looks really rough.
Oh, my God.
It's got worms. It's got everything got that a worms. Butthole needs. But yeah.
All right. I don't think one needs those. I'm pretty sure you don't want
well,
those.
Well, you know, is your butt really real if you haven't had a hemorrhoid or worms coming out of it? Come on.
Well, let me tell you.
Okay, I'm listening.
How many people in here have had a hemorrhoid?
I have. In this podcast? It's rough.
Yeah, I've had them.
We're old. Hey, 4 for 4. We're yeah, all right. old.
Hey, you forget, dude. We're all in our 30s.
Don't forget to push. Mm. All right. Bramble Familiar.
No, you're not supposed to push. You gotta wait.
Yeah, you're supposed to...
Sometimes you can't, bro.
All right, guys. Let's talk about our Metamucil that we're taking tomorrow morning.
Whatever happened to the days of just reading a newspaper article? Like, I'm going to save this for when I take a shit. Okay? Whatever happened to those days?
The problem is that we have a cell phone. You sit on the toilet for way too long. That's the issue.
Yeah, then you have to wait till you get those little red marks where your
dude,
knees are.
Dude, that's prime meme posting time.
Where you put your elbows.
Right. Every time I'm sending memes that I make specifically, I'm on the toilet.
Yeah. The indicator that you've been on too long is when you have those big red circles from your elbows. Like
or you stand up and you all fall over because you're like, numb, dude.
All right, back to Bramble Familiar.
All right, fetch quest, 7 mana.
Yeah.
Mill 7 cards, then put a creature, enchantment, or land card from among them onto the battlefield.
Yeah.
From the milled cards,
yeah.
Specifically.
They keep doing so that. Can't, I hate that.
You can't reanimate anything in the graveyard, which is kind of lame, but whatever. And then it's other side cost 2, and it taps to add a green, and then you can tap a green and a colorless and discard a card to return it to your hand. So you get to recast it over and over if you really want to.
The fetch quest, yeah. Elemental.
Does Cascade work with adventures?
Doesn't.
Okay.
Yeah, it hits the combination total.
No,
that's why they can play. Yeah.
No, it doesn't.
That's why they play Brazen Bower.
Right.
They play Brazen Bower because it's a 3-drop creature. And
oh, won't. That's right. So it won't get hit by any of the cascades.
And I'm the one that doesn't play magic.
The one that counts both is when it's a split card. That's why they play Fire.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. They changed that rule too. That was so bizarre. Like the initial, they've changed that rule like 3 times because of Bob. But yeah. All right. Blossoming Turtle.
This card. I like this card.
Turtle.
This is the meme card.
This is the best card. So
this is the one where you can do a bunch of crazy dumb garbage with.
So yeah,
I don't know if this card's a meme, but he's definitely cool.
It's green 2 for a turtle. Whenever Blossoming Tortoise enters the battlefield or attacks, mill three cards, then return a land from your graveyard to the battlefield tap. So this has got the other phrasing, which is like just bring back land. So pretty cool. Activated abilities of lands you control cost 1 less to activate. Key thing on this is it doesn't stop it from costing 1, or like you can't reduce it. Other cards of this like style, like Zerda, say like that you can't change the activated ability under 1, and this one lets it. And then lands because you control costs 1 less. So with a deserted temple, you can just sit there playing with yourself.
I have a question.
What is the symbol you put on this card?
OnlyFans.
Oh my god!
Because you sit there and play with yourself with it.
Oh
heck yeah!
So you know, Imprison in the Moon, right?
What about that?
Yeah. Straight into truck.
Okay, so if I make like a planeswalker into, well, I guess not a planeswalker. Let's say a creature with an activated ability that costs 1.
Okay.
Colorless. Mm-hmm. Into a land. Mm-hmm. And then I copy that land with Thespian Stage.
It wouldn't have the ability because Prison in the Moon says it doesn't have abilities.
Judge, I don't know.
I was about to say, if you could do that, if you could do some wonky stuff with that, that'd be so funny.
There's plenty of wonky stuff you could already do with this card.
All right, I'm looking this up because I need to know.
No, in Prison Legend, like, says that like the combo where you have three turtles and dark depths.
Yeah, three turtles.
That's my favorite combo.
Triple tortoise and dark depths.
that's my favorite combo. Oh, you just got to play all the clones.
That's right, Colby. Sorry, what is exactly right? You can't figure that out. No, yeah, you just play all the clones.
Oh, I didn't think about that, huh? What,
triple tortoise and...
Yeah.
I posted it in the chat. Whatever, dude.
We posted that. That was my favorite one. I saw that and I was like, oh my God, that's amazing.
Check this out. Instant 2020. What's up? Yeah, dude.
Just play a hex mage and, you know, do it right away.
No, wait.
Or he should be a 3/4. Or he should have, like, a big butt because he's a turtle.
Yeah. They should have given him Shroud or something. I don't know. Or a shield token. Whatever. Either way.
You have 4 toughness.
Think you have that bot set up, dude.
Hold on. I just read this from a magic judge ruling. Thespian stage copying an imprisoned in the moon card makes it become that card as a land.
Yeah, but it would still not have abilities.
Pretty weird.
It has the abilities.
So you're able to like get degen with that. What are you doing with it?
Oh, I'll look it up.
All right, pussy. Thanks.
Screw having original ideas. I'm gonna look it up.
Yeah, you can come up with triple tortoise and dark depths. The greatest combo you've ever seen.
I need to look at creatures that have 1 mana activated abilities.
That's all I got. So if this week in the stream they announce jumpstart cards. However, Wilds of Eldraine will not have jumpstart packs. It seems like this is a thing they're going away with. Melissa Del Torres, who's part of the
almost like everyone complained and said they were terrible. And
well,
no
they just didn't.
Them.
They just didn't sell. Like it was just a bad product from the get go. But because they are a year out from design,
you say that because the anime jumpstart cards that jumpstart sold just fine.
That was an isolated product. That wasn't an
That's
additional.
What I mean.
Yeah. So
yeah,
fair
the
enough.
Two that were isolated did good, but the ones that are set based are.
So
terrible.
I hope they don't get rid of them because I want more anime cards, but.
Sure.
You're getting a bunch in this set.
Yeah.
Anyways, they come up with a bunch of cards. You can look them up. All of them are pretty underpowered. They're cute, but they're just like random cards. So, jumpstart cards only exist exclusively in set and collect boosters, RIP draft boosters, because they want to kill draft boosters.
Cool.
Here's all the different cards it came out with.
I need that.
Yeah.
The blue card seems fine.
Fairy Slumber Party.
Yeah, I need it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's alright. It's pretty medium.
You get 2 1/1s per creature.
The worst art I've ever seen of Rowdy Research. Like, Jesus Christ, man. What is that face? This is one of the all-time worst looking things I've ever seen.
That's the face you make when you're losing to someone you don't think you should be.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the face your opponent makes.
Tilt your head slightly
when you cast this card, because this card sucks. I agree, Colby. Instead of trying to shove it limited into a beginner product, you are correct. So this card actually has the caveat of for each creature that attacked this turn. So it's not just your creatures, it's any creature. So if someone's like, I'm token deck, you're like, Ancestral, what's up? these are legal in Standard, Pioneer, and all that. So if any of these things pop off, they will be $1 million because they're incredibly hard to get. And by that, I mean they're exclusive to...
Set boosters and up, right?
Set boosters and collector boosters. And the reason why they're going to be hard to get is because they're also in that exclusive spot alongside the Eternal Legal stuff only from this set that's also in set and collector boosters. So nothing really too crazy. Also, look at this thing's charging Hooligan's neck. Like, what is this? Who made
That's a thumb, bro.
Dude, why does the arm, why does the shoulder and the neck look like it's like connected under there?
Aligned.
Yeah, like, it's real
And
bad.
His other arm is like rubber, dude. It's like curled.
Oh, yeah, it's terrible. Like, whoever did this AI-generated art, man, you should have checked.
They needed a filler AI card last minute.
Dude, it's so bad.
It does look like AI art, almost.
Well, just based on that neck.
I would hate to be an artist.
I do
right
think
now.
The Become Brutes is really good.
Yeah.
Because, we were just trashing that art, and I'm sure, I'm sure that artist put a lot of work into it, but, I would hate to be an artist right now with the rise of AI and just the criticism people get. And,
oh, yeah. That's good. It's
how convincing some of it can be, and like all of that. It's like got to be a rough place to be an artist.
I stopped believing in art when they printed that faithless looting.
Yeah, well, I
like that faithless looting. I like that one.
It's cool. I'm glad you like it, but it's actually just terrible.
Dude, what's crazy about, like, this is gonna be a little bit off tangential, but AI art hasn't figured it out, so it's pretty easy to spot still. Like, it's not clean. Whereas, like, the AI-generated songs are, like someone did, like, an AI-generated Post Malone song, and it sounds like fucking Post Malone. It's like, oh, yeah. this is fucked. Like, that's a little scary. And then also, like, comedians, you can type in, like, ChatGPT, like, because they have so much, like, YouTube and whatever out there, so much, like mainstream comedians, so, like, create a joke with this premise sounding like Tom Segura, and then they just pop something out back at you. You're like, that does sound like me. Holy shit. Like, so it is what it is. Just right. Off subject there. Ogre Chitler, though, however, that card is a red 4 for a menace 6/5, and it's like a Grave Titan. When it enters or attacks, create 2 1/1 black rat creature tokens. This creature can't block. Then if you control 5 or more rats, each rat you control gets +2/+0. Until end of turn. So this card's cool.
Wow, that card busted.
That's cool. It's like Grave Titan, but like rare.
Dude, yeah. Go Hog Wild. I would hate to have to play against this name.
In the pre-release.
Yeah. You can't get these in pre-release because you have to open draft boosters in that.
Oh, boo.
Yeah, I know. But
dude, Go Hog Wild has got to be the best like name that for an Ogre D
for my Super Aspect though.
And then Wildwood Mentor and Provision Merchant. These cards, like the jump cards, like cards are supposed to suck because they don't want them to be like damning or needed for standard because they're hard to get. So thank God they did that.
Tell that to the first jumpster.
Yeah, no kidding. Well, the first one that has like that one angel that like that's like $11 that's played in the Pioneer Angel deck. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, dude. These cards rule. The Eternal Exclusive cards. So there's 8 cards in the set total. Yeah, 8 or maybe 9. 8 cards in the set total that are Eternal Exclusive that, you can only get from set boosters or collector boosters. Whoa. So there's your confusion. I like that
throne.
That throne is awesome.
Why is this? This is from the Commanders?
No, these are not in the Commander decks.
Booster Explosives.
Yeah.
Because doesn't WOC at the bottom stand for Wilds of Commander?
Maybe, but either way, it's that symbol is represented that it's for Eternal formats only. You can't. Okay. There's only 2 Commander decks coming out. Neither of these are in those. But this Throne of Eldraine enters the battlefield, choose a color, and then it's 5 mana for a legendary artifact, and then you can tap it to add 4 mana of the chosen color. Spend this mana only to cast monocolored spells of that color. This card is nuts. I think this card's so sick.
Cool. I'll be picking up 3 copies for various pulls.
Dude, it's tap add 4 mana. Like that's Guild of Lotus is
like, EDH.
Yeah. And then 3 tap draw 2 cards, spend this mana only.
That's what's crazy.
Yeah. So it's pretty good.
Even if you don't want the ramp ability, just drawing 2 cards for 3 mana in a monocolored deck is amazing.
Yeah, so that's like a pretty big pickup. Yeah. They have Bernard, Ginger Sculptor, Food and Golem thing, but the idea of it is like when creatures die, it makes them into a gingerbread man, and then it has all the same abilities, which is pretty cool, and then also food on top of it, so that's a fun one. And then they did this whole court cycle to be monarchs again, so there's a whole cycle of them, there's the red, green, and so forth. So far, I haven't seen any that are...
Standout busted.
The black one's sick. The black one is really good. The blue one's okay. You gotta see this black one. So they're all court of something, and it looks like they're court of named based on the last land cycle that was from.
I was reading Lockthwain today, and I was like, oh, that seems pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty sick. So for black 2, it's an enchantment. When Court of Lockthwain enters the battlefield, you become the monarch. At the beginning of your upkeep, exile the top card of target opponent's library. You may play that card for as long as it remains exiled, and mana of any type so you can spend any mana to cast it. If you are the monarch, until end of turn, you may cast a card from among the exiled cards without paying its mana cost. So, yeah, pretty sick. Card rules. The other ones are kind of like meh. You said you like the blue one?
No, I was saying from the last cycle of these from Commander Legends.
Yeah.
The blue one that's all playing Legacy for a little bit.
For sure. And then lastly, they did the Korvald, the Gleeful Glutton, which this card stinks. They were so hyped on this on stream. They were like hyping this up. They're like, we know it's not as good as the old Korvald, but it's pretty strong. I'm like, no, it's not. This card stinks to high heaven.
Yeah. Looked bad.
Yeah, it's an 8 mana.
Yeah, call. Cheated it into play. The attack trigger is pretty good.
Nah.
It's big, fast.
You would just always want to play Korvald instead of this. Like, I just don't know.
Color one
can't be played in standard. Never mind.
One of these, like, courts look really is really good.
Yeah.
We
black one.
The black one's
whole
good.
Combo.
Yeah, the black one's pretty sick.
It's not this one. It's not this one that's good.
It's the black one.
Really good.
The black one's sick. So this Korvald is jund 5, so 8 mana total. This spell costs 1 less for to cast for each card type among permanents you've sacrificed this turn. So if you sacrifice a land, which a fetch land makes it cost 1 cheaper, and an artifact, which makes it cost 1 cheaper, it's cost 6. The likelihood of you sacking, like, creature enchantment, the whole brigade of stuff, it's, like, pretty low.
And we got food clue tokens now, too, though. You gotta remember, that's 2 types.
Oh, no.
It's card. Still an artifact.
They're both artifacts.
Oh, yeah.
It's Fardies. Yeah, and then
legendary
it's got...
creature would count as 2, right?
Yeah, no. Korvald is mids at best.
No, because legendary is a super type, creature is a type, and then a subtype is the thing that you see to the right. Dragon Noble. Every day I have to hear about how I don't play Magic, but yet you simpletons...
Well,
you don't. We're not lying.
What about tribal? Isn't that a super type?
It is.
Nope.
But then how come that counts?
Okay. Super type?
Well, not really. Tribal doesn't exist anymore.
Well, hold on. Let me take that back. Sorry. Tribal's a subtype. I'm sorry.
Oh. Okay.
No, maybe it is a type.
Yeah. So who's the idiot now? Yeah. Legendary and creature are two different types.
Every time I think of types, I have to think of Tarmogoyf and go, what is on the list?
A super type would be like snow.
Yep. Snow. Legendary is a super type. And then subtypes are obviously whatever this bull crap is over here. Anyways,
yes, this card is bad.
What's a world enchantment?
It's an enchantment. They retconned all of them.
Are you sure?
Did they?
No,
sure?
No.
I don't think so.
No, you're wrong.
Yeah.
When they reprinted Court of Calling, it came out, it just said enchantment.
Doesn't say world enchantment, dude.
Let me.
It was just reprinted in
secret layer.
Double Masters. I thought they got rid of
Yeah.
I was like, are you sure?
Do you know how world enchantments work?
Double Masters,
No, there can only be one.
Correct.
I just know that much.
Yes. So if I have
Concordant
Crossroads and you play the Abyss, kills my Concordant Crossroads. Yeah, it's confusing.
This should just change it back to enchantments.
No, because I don't want two of these in play. That'd be ridiculous.
Why would two in play matter?
Double haste.
Now you're just getting crazy. Dude, stop
this
it.
This would suck, though.
Swing harder.
Six or whatever. I think Chains of Mistopheles is a world enchantment.
Yeah, they only come from Legends, and they're like, we got to stop this, because when people are getting really pissed off that nobody's reading the rules, and everybody's just got like 3 Concordant Crossroads in play. There's a big deal.
That's the card they cared about.
Yeah, nobody wanted 3 Abysses in play. Is the Abyss the one that makes everything cost 3, or is that the other one?
The Abyss makes, it adds 3.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, so nobody wanted 3 of those in play. Everything costs 9 more, guys.
You. That sounds great to me. Exactly the kind of deck I want to play.
No, I like trash, baby. All right. Anyways. Lastly, some more Enchanting Tales. Jeff, get ready to claim your dreams. Jeans, whatever.
Yeah, Jeff.
Yeah, or JB, whatever. You guys like cream and stuff.
Dude, this
art whatever.
Repercussion.
That card.
I don't remember what this card... Like, what is this originally from?
I have no idea.
It's got to be Urza Saga.
They should have reprinted, instead of this, they should have reprinted Pandemonium. That would have been cooler.
Yeah.
Isn't that picture looks very like a meme. Dude, that Phyrexian on life is cool.
What, this one? Or this one?
Yeah. Isn't that Bonecrusher Giant in the art?
This one right here?
No.
Yeah.
I've seen that art before.
Yeah, okay. Phyrexian on life does look really cool.
Sick.
Yeah.
It does look good.
The ground suit is kind of sick, too.
This is the alien that Josh was talking about. Mediocre
card.
This is the alien that Josh was talking about at the beginning of
the episode.
Yeah.
Right.
Hardened scales. All right, we got a somewhat modern playable card printed.
Yeah.
Also, I can't wait to see
Blood Moon is printed. Modern playable. What?
I can't wait to see Dawn of Hope in anime. Oh.
Mm-hmm. Just like this Paralyze.
Oh man, this is so goofy.
I'm so sad that I have an Innistrad foil one. It's worthless now.
Yep. You don't have anime. You're done.
I do like the anime one. The other one.
I like
weird.
The OG one way better.
Paralyze.
Or the other one better.
The double wolves. Yeah.
Yeah, that one. That's my.
This guy's got such a sturdy chin. It's unbelievable.
Dude, this looks like it's straight out of like Fire Emblem.
This, yep. Yeah, that probably
parallel,
is.
The parallel lives, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Like it.
I'm an idiot.
Omniscience, this one.
I'm also on team the regular art over the anime.
No, anime art
that's
all the
fine.
Way.
Yo, double thick thighs, double double gobble up.
There's no feet though.
Damn.
They're covered by claw or clouds.
I think the normal art is better than the anime art.
Yeah. I mean, they're both great.
Oh,
dude.
This is what I'm going to say. I said it last week.
Yeah.
The other alt arts are really cool. I have to be the anime guy, so I cannot get the anime version.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z. I just can't put OnlyFans on the magic cards.
Why not?
It's not OnlyFans.
Rest in peace is kind of playable.
Cool. Yeah.
I'm ready for that.
Dude, yes.
Yeah,
let's
go that one looks cool.
I want to get one to put in.
There's too much going on in that rip.
Yeah, it's too much. I can't tell if they're going to space or going to have
a graveyard. I can't tell what's going on. Yeah.
Okay, it's not. This is a space graveyard. Look at this planet.
Show me the anime one. Get me the anime one. Where is it?
I'm sorry.
I know they haven't shown it.
And Pat Tremors, the stocks on that is going down.
I mean, they were only a dollar or two, anyways. But...
Nah, dude, they were like $4.
Yeah, I can imagine. It's like an EDH. Powerhouse.
It has a regular printing and then it was printed in a secret layer. Is it? And now it's got a printing that's on an uncommon, so everyone's got them now. Force Fruition. I remember this card's from Lorwyn and I don't remember.
Now like a card or some shit for no reason.
It's like a decent price.
The Nekuthar made that card expensive.
Is that what made it expensive? That's fair. Okay. You also can just
It stops your opponent from like winning a lot of the time. Like,
it's just
milk. Yeah.
Well, not milling the drawing, but yeah.
Well, whatever, you know, they.
Utopia Swirl is like a $4 card. Now that's going to be nothing, which is good. Like, I hate when uncommons are expensive.
Dude, this game is too expensive.
Don't even talk to me.
It's like $120.
Dude, I am so excited for the ley lines to get printed. I saw the Sanctity and I was like, wait, yeah. Did they only do that?
They did Leyline of Anticipation. They have to do Void because those are the like Void is
they
like
did.
Vintage. They did okay. I saw the Leyline of Sanctity and Void are like 60 card playable, and then like Anticipation is like EDH gold.
Yeah. So I'm pumped for all three of those.
Do they pick? Which
I also like Dark Tutelage. Dark Tutelage is a cool card.
The newest one. Probably.
I like that they dropped that to an
uncommon.
Before that goes in the cube.
Oh yeah, and then you gotta get the anime one.
Nope.
Karma Justice. I like this one.
Getting ready to get beheaded.
Yeah, dude. You can either get beheaded
that,
by
see, that anime art's not so bad.
Why not?
Dude, it looks like Dark Souls.
I still think I take the
What's
left
different?
One.
What's different?
Because I like the antlers.
Yeah, you're all. Well, they both got antlers, but this one's green and this one's brown. Brown makes
that one
more sense.
That one's just not sex appeal. There's no sex appeal in that one. That's why I like.
Damn.
That's why I like that one.
No sex
appeal do you see in the other
I'm not
one.
Trying to get a boner while I'm playing.
What boner are you getting from that, bro? That was a dude in night outfits cutting a dude's head off. What are you into, bro?
Let me go to your
I'm comparing it to the omniscience.
Hey, do me a favor. Go ahead and pull up your browser and type in www.ehent. Let me see what you're into. Let me see what you've bookmarked.
That's
blind obedience.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet. And then Stab Wound, which is...
Stab Wound.
Ooh, that card was a doozy.
That card is sick.
In draft, that card was unreal.
That card was a doozy.
Yeah, put that in cute.
That card was tough to deal with. Yo. And As Foretold.
As Foretold.
It's got some Miyazaki vibe going on, though.
Yeah.
Spirited Away.
It's pretty bright. This makes me think of Power Stone.
Yeah.
The game. Like,
dude, on Dreamcast.
Yeah, what other station was it on?
PlayStation. Making sure.
That's it. That's all I got for today.
Oh, yeah. But so also Void, Anticipation, isn't and the green one that gives 1/1 counters.
Right, well, since we're all
in the red one, it's the original one, isn't it? The really bad one?
Yeah, the really bad one no one likes.
All right, hold on, hold on. I got to get to these deck lists. But keep talking about As Foretold, because I foretold you.
I want it to be a good card. I like As Foretold.
Did you hear that 6 of these cards are pre-banned in Historic?
Yes, yeah, Spreading Seas, Blood Moon is supposed to be one of them.
Yeah, they banned Spreading Seas.
Have we gotten the anime Spreading Seas yet?
No.
Dang.
It's just going to be the Little Mermaid.
I hope so. All right.
I hope it's just giant feet. I'm going to get it for Josh because he loves Spreading Seas.
All right, dudes. So the Wild of Eldraine's Commander deck list, they have exclusive cards in each of them. But that
do
being
not
said,
read all these to me.
I'm not going to. The green white one is like an aura themed deck, and it's got some pretty cool auras that are going on with it. But they also printed like good cards, like Bear Umbra, that was already reprinted. But what is
Ring
Retether? Since hasn't gotten printed since Planar Shift, Planar Shift is what it's called, I think. That one's pretty good.
Plane Shift.
I'm sorry. Is it Plane Shift? No, Plane Shift is different. Planar.
Okay. I got a question.
Chaos. Planar Chaos.
This is unrelated to these.
All right, buddy.
Got Angelic Destiny. If I played Ring Out in every blue EDH deck I had, do you think people would get mad?
Yes.
Which one's Ring Out?
It's
the one that you just go into your deck, get it out when the person casts the Soul Ring, and then counter target Soul Ring.
Yeah, boring.
Hates the first Soul Ring.
I don't think people would get mad.
No.
Perfect. Everyone hates the first Soul Ring.
If they did get mad, then whatever. Chaos, yeah. Then you actually won the game. If you tilted them like that, then you actually won.
I gotta get a couple copies
of
that.
You got a reaction out of them.
Yeah.
I gotta get a couple copies of that card.
I'm
love sure it.
They're like $100 is what they're charging.
The turtle,
like 20.
The turtle also makes these just tap for 2 mana versus having to pay 1 to filter.
Yep. Yeah, I saw that. That's pretty great.
I love that turtle.
Mana base still looks trash like always.
Well, I don't care. They came like Daybreak Coronet, Angelic Destiny. Like, these are real cards. Like, I like.
Haven't we always bitched about how the mana base is trash every time?
One it wasn't was like the
Halls
Lord
of
the Rings.
Halls of Heliod's Generosity. Like, it's got some good stuff in here. That's pretty good. I like it. Worf.
Why not just give them?
Stop putting temples in here and make the temples uncommon.
This card was randomly expensive because it was only printed in Rise of Eldrazi Umbra Mystic.
Yeah.
They have a bunch of like
why
random
wouldn't
cards.
They,
that are,
why wouldn't they just print Horizon Canopy in here?
I don't know. They already printed a bunch of cards.
Why not even just put what's the fetch land that only gets basics? Prismatic
the newer
Vista.
One? Prismatic Vista, yeah.
All right.
No, they got to give you the bad one, the cheap one.
Dude, they don't have. I can't believe.
Wait, what colors is that fairy?
Blue black.
What's that thing do?
Who cares?
What do you say? Who cares? I care.
Brazen Bar is in this one for some reason.
Ooh, nice.
They just threw that in there.
Dude, what if they put in Glenelendra specifically?
Glenelendra.
This is a good deck.
Sign of Una. Sauron.
This is basically what I put together.
This deck of rules.
Seriously, this is basically the deck I put together.
Yeah, I can't believe they don't have Spellstorius right. What a fucking fail on that.
They could have had the anime one. Come on.
Dig Through Time.
Damn, dude, really?
Yeah, I'm telling you,
this is a good deck.
Like, these are, like, I can't believe how good these were. I was like, oh my god.
This is 100% most of the deck that I put together.
Yeah.
It's great. I even put Midnight Clock in mine.
Yeah, this is good. All around, just, like, fantastic job on these decks. They look good.
Nah, that first one, whatever.
That being said, let's go to Scryfall.
For what?
Because I want to show you.
That you can look up commander decks in here because that's
no. They're because the exclusive cards you can't look up on Wizard's site because they suck. Because like,
yeah, it doesn't show the
what
picture.
What does that mean?
Mm-hmm.
The exclusive cards in the
so
decks,
this card, Archmage of Echoes, flying, Ward 2.
Oh, this is great.
Whenever you cast a fairy or a wizard permanent spell, copy it.
This is great.
This card is sick.
I'm playing the hell
out
of it.
I love this card.
Can I get this in foil?
Yeah, no. You can.
Well,
no,
it might come in set in collector box.
It does. It does. Yep.
Ah,
it does.
Okay.
But it'll only be full art foil.
Yeah, I'm trying to foil out my.
It does. This card's pretty cool too.
Fairies.
I love this card too. It's like a midnight clock. Essentially, just you get to redeclare attackers for someone else. you get to select new players and permanents for them.
That's funny.
Goofy.
Like, go over there. Like,
someone's gonna kill you.
I like those cards. There's like a cursed mirror card that came in one of those sets, and it's like the same kind of vibe.
I'm gonna have to look through this list.
It's pretty good. Like, all these cards are pretty. Unfinished Business is pretty good.
Knick-knack.
Oof.
Click on the ox.
This one, every time you attack somebody, you give them an ox, but you draw a card. And then that's it. You give them a 2/4 ox when you attack somebody.
Got him.
A trade.
It can't be blocked by oxen.
It can't be blocked by oxen. I like that.
I'm telling you, these commander decks, I think they did a good job on them.
Like, I bet there's only two of them.
Yeah. I didn't really look at the other stuff that came with it, but yeah.
That card's real good.
Yeah, I saw that card and I was just like, oh, and wizards? I was like,
whoa, what
so
is the
sick.
Land?
It's just Secluded Glen. That's a river.
Yeah.
That's okay.
What they showed during whatever.
It's a river.
Okay, well, these are sick. I'm pretty dumb. Dope. Let's go to Scryfall to see if they have any other enchanting tales that are anime yet. Because they definitely came out with more today, and I just wasn't paying attention at all. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, they didn't show them in anime. It was just most of them weren't in anime. I'm excited to see The Void. Dude, I got... anyone want Japanese old bordered TSR chalice, or not chalice, but voids? Whatever, ley line of
void? Foil?
Not
foil. Regular.
How much are they?
I don't know. The Japanese ones? Yeah. Not that much.
20
twins? Probably like $10.
What the hell is this card?
I'll give you 10 for all four.
For all four? No. Let me tell you. 15, that's what it is.
Maybe.
Artifacts you control, is this still a reprint?
Food fight? No. Because you have to have multiple food fights out.
Oh, yeah. Alright, yeah, this set looks good. Huge upgrade. That draw two is. Divination's only sorcery.
Oh, it was? I thought it was instant for some reason.
Everyone thinks that they're all wrong. What's this? Oh yeah, these.
I mean,
are
it
the...
only took like a bajillion years to like power creep it.
I can't read this. Jeff, JB, tell me what this is.
Click on it, I'll let you know.
No.
Click on the mythic. Yeah.
It's a shock.
Deals non-combat damage to an opponent. You may exile that many cards from the top of your library.
So
seems
fine. With fury, you get to draw 4.
Yeah. Mm. It's only to an opponent. It's to an opponent.
It's super farts. But this deal 2 damage is kind of cute. Embereth Blaze.
5 mana is so much.
It's too much for drawing cards. Like, the game's already over by then. Like, they got a shield
especially
to play.
If you're playing Burn.
Yeah. Ward, Bunny. This is just the
same. Horned Lock Whale.
Yeah, I'm not reading that. All right. Josh, get me out of here.
You guys ready for this one?
Yeah.
Yu-Gi-Oh's better than Magic. It's Wednesday, my dudes.
What could you?
For real, it's like $80 for a box.
What, for Yu-Gi-Oh?
Yeah.
I agree, dude. Yu-Gi-Oh's tight.
Magic's too expensive. I'm like, Jim's like, did you get our boxes yet? And I'm like, dreading. I'm like, God damn it, dude. I don't have any money.
I don't want to.
I'm already not eating.
Yeah.
Damn, son.
Right.
You just gotta start eating pickles from trash.
Dude, that's all that's in my fucking fridge right now, pickles.
Because they last forever.
Right? Like,
I was saving these for a sandwich, but I ran out of money. I guess I'll have to use this for sustenance.
Ever since I was a kid, I've hated you.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to it. Shout out to it.
Paper player, it's stupid.
Thanks, Marshall. I know you watch the show too. Yeah.
All right, I'm out of here.
Seems.
I need that ass for gold.
You need everything.
I know.
Gotta go to.
I will consume all of this product.
Goldfish.
Find out when As Foretold was played last.
Let's see, because they're way faster on spoilers.
Dreaming.
No, not really. The whole set should be revealed on Friday because pre-release is next week.
Yeah, so show me all the goddamn altars.
Never.
The case played on Sunday.
I don't think I'll be able to.
So let's say Tony can't even come to normal, man. He ain't fucking coming to that.
Oh, I was just saying that I was going.
So you're asking.
Most of the time, I don't ask him anymore because if he can go, he'll say he can go.
No, I'll be, yeah, I'll let you guys know.
And then half of the time, you won't go anyway.
Yeah. Like, I'm get. Are you going to be at Legacy on Friday, Tony?
Mm-mm.
Dang.
I have a pretty stacked weekend, so like, if I want to, you're do
coming
this,
to coming to Ren Faire?
Probably not.
Damn.
When are you going to Ren Faire?
The second.
Yeah.
Oh, the next Saturday.
Yeah. Before they close up.
Yeah. I don't
What's
know.
That fairy rogue do up there? Go back.
These all that suck. One.
That one to the left right there. What's that do?
It gives you counters for whenever a fairy does damage. If you attack with three fairies, you get a 1/1 counter on it. And then when it dies,
yeah, I'll play that. It's
pretty soft.
I don't care.
I hate the art on this fairy. It doesn't
it's a themed
good.
Deck. I don't care. I'm playing nothing but fairy shit.
You gotta get this one. This one gives
people, play that one
this
too.
One gives 4/2 pirates to people that are goaded for the rest of the game, so they can't attack you.
Huh.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. And this one's destroy all creatures and then create 3/1/1 fairies. Yep, pretty sick.
Oh, that's super good.
And then you know, we haven't gotten this yet. Unless so. Just realized.
Yeah.
They haven't said they're going to put some crazy full portrait land in yet. Wonder if they're giving up on that finally.
I hope.
What do you mean?
Like the basics, they're always full. There's always like the regular ones and then a full portrait one.
Yeah, they did. The forest, they did that.
They did?
Yeah, they suck. Yeah, nothing special because everything's special, so it kind of blows. Right there.
Oh.
They're actually not too bad.
The green one looks... Okay. I like the green one just because it's super green.
Yeah.
But that's about it.
Yeah, so every set has these, so therefore, you know, get fucked judges. You don't get cool stuff. Idiots.
Oh, yeah, don't they get the...
The full arts that are not distinguishable other than having a tiny bird on them.
Yeah.
Yeah. They should have gave them, like... I don't really know. Honestly, when they did the full arts, remember when they did the basic lands that were all full text? They should have given those to judges only. That would have been more thematic than what they
basics
did.
Basics so yeah. much.
Yeah, that would have been smart. But they do crappy stuff. Well, I shouldn't say they do crappy stuff. They just, I guess they don't care. The greatest moments of history.
For the full art, they should have done them where they literally have no border. Just one giant picture that says like island.
Jesus, chalices are on the rise, huh? Ulamog's what?
Wrong Ulamog.
Why is this $42? The one ring, 65, Resplendent Angel.
Still need my fourth ring, damn it.
This is going up for some reason. Oh, Splinter Twin's down to I love how this card stays at $15. It's playable in nothing, but it's only got one printing. Holy crap, these are $80? Oh my god. I guess it's never been reprinted. Holy guacamole.
It'll be... Aren't we getting Innistrad Masters after Ravnica Masters?
I'm so... Oh dude, I can't... These are $75. I missed the boat. Whoops.
Jeff, you have 2, right? Not 3.
I keep finding these in bulk boxes. Seriously, I just keep finding them. It's really nice. And
Splinter Twin is only $8.
All right, whatever.
And it has been reprinted.
Yeah, it was. You're right.
It was in Modern Masters 2015 and the list.
The list is
I just think that MTG Goldfish uses like the medium price on a lot of stuff.
Yeah, it's fine. I do like watching like things go up and down. I like watching prices. Have one of these sitting. Farewell. Those are pretty nice. Beside you.
Savior. Yeah, Chalice is like $50. In fact, you can get one for Masters 25 for like 48.
Yeah. Biggest winners this week. Why did this go up so much?
Enchantments are coming.
Good point, yeah. Okay. I was really interested, real intrigued by high price changes. I guess I don't know. I haven't
purchased... Opened, dude, that That's how I won the draft on Sunday. My pick one was Sarah Paragon.
The white two? Yeah, that card's sick.
Yeah, and all I had like double and triple of the 2 and 3 drops that when they come in, they make a token.
Yeah.
So right, it's just like when they die, I'll just cast them again, and I just flooded the board.
How many shields do you own? Because they're $70.
I've got 4. Why?
All right, good move.
Why?
Just curious.
Because when standard season comes. Although the Pro Tour is going to be standard, so we might see an emergency band if it's nothing but Shieldred in the top 8.
I find it hard to like see if it would be anything other than that, you know?
Mm-hmm. Because the top deck is like blue-black right now. Pioneer. Pioneer suck.
Esper, red deck wins? Okay, that's pretty cool. Arena is like...
Yeah, Demir aggro do 14%.
That's all right.
Followed by Mono Black aggro at 8%.
Yeah, both those.
Both are on... Yeah, Shieldred.
Yeah, Shieldred is
the... You have 4 and 5 color control. With,
the fact that a red deck can exist while Shieldred is still here is pretty impressive. Because that card just was like, you're going to lose now.
I think they have a card that deals 5... Maybe I can't remember if there's one in standard.
Probably just kill them faster than it matters.
This card's really good too. Lilac deck card. Kumanu.
Oh, they have a damage doubler in the board too.
What's this? This one? Oh, this is
no.
This is
that one deals 5 though. That kills Shieldred. That.
This is +1. This card's so annoying. I've played against this like a million times. Yeah. I haven't really played any standard, I don't know. I'm waiting for standard to matter somewhere else, you know?
We're on modern season, so once that's over, standard will start mattering.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Man. I don't know about Josh talking about his...
I don't really care.
We're still streaming, by the way.
I know.
Okay.
I'm aware. I just want to get 2 games in before I have to go to bed. I can't believe how beat out it I am.
I bet, man. Well, you gentlemen have a good one. I'm gonna go play some more Pokemon.
I'm getting out of here.
Switch.
Bye bye.
See yas. Stream is